Jazallahu bil khayrati anna a'immatan lana naqalu al-Qur'ana 'azban wa salsala faminhum budurun sab'atun qad tawasatat sama' al-'ula wal-'adl zuhran wa kummala.
In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about the third marhala, al-marhalatu al-thalitha, the third stage. We spoke about the first stage and the second stage in our previous episode of how the Qur'an reached us. Remember, we're in the al-adilla al-qati'a, the clear-cut evidences that the Qur'an and the qira'at have both reached us bit-tawatur, in multitude, mass transmission. We spoke about the first stage, which was the Prophet ﷺ to his companions. And then we spoke about the companions to the tabi'een, to their students, the companions to their students. And now we're going to speak about the third one, which is the students of the companions, which are the tabi'een, passing it on to the atba'u tabi'een, and then onwards. And then how it reached us is the final stage, inshallah ta'ala. The Qur'an was passed on in mass transmission from the Sahabas to the tabi'een. I've already proved the story of Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, how his students reached in one gathering 1,600. We spoke about that in our previous episode. Here, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about the tabi'een and how they passed on the Qur'an and they taught the Qur'an and the number of people they taught the Qur'an to, the tabi'een, and how the atba'u tabi'een took from a lot of the tabi'een. That's the one, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to start with. It was narrated that Yahya ibn Abdullah ibn Ubaydillah ibn Abdullah ibn Abi Mulayka and Abu al-Hasan Alamuddin al-Sakhawi, he narrated this in his kitab Jamalul Qurra. He narrated it there that Ibn Abi Mulayka said, "Nahnu law wajadna rajulan, if we find a man yaqra'u reciting bima laysa bayna al-lawhayn, and is reciting that which is not between the two covers, ma kana baynana wa baynahu illa at-tawbah, the only thing that we're going to request from that person who's reading the Quran that is not between the two covers, the thing that we're going to request from him is repentance, aw tudrab 'unuqahu, or is going to get capital punishment from the Islamic state, naji'u bihi 'an al-ummah, naji'u bihi 'an al-ummah, we take this Qur'an from a ummah, a mass transmission, a large quantity of people. Anil ummah, from a large quantity of a people we pass it on to." So yani, we've taken it off from mass number of people. Who they took from mass number of people. Who took from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who took from Jibreel. Who took from Allah azza wa jalla. وَتَقُولُونَ, and you guys are now coming to us and saying to us, حَدَّثَنَا فُلَانُ الْأَعْرَجِ عَنْ فُلَانِ الْأَعْمَى مَا أَدْرِي مَاذَا, and here you are coming to us telling us so-and-so told us, so-and-so told us, so-and-so told us. And we don't take the Qur'an from so-and-so. We take the Qur'an from mass transmission. Ibn Abi Mulayka is an imam who lived at the second century of Islam. And he was a tabi'i. He was from the tabi'i. And his statement here is very powerful. What did he just say? What he said was, and he categorically said it, is that we have taken the Qur'an from a mass number of people. So mass number of people. Who took from a mass number of people, who took from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who took from Jibreel wa ma ila dhalik, to Allah azza wa jalla. And in mass transmission. This is the tabi'in saying this. What supports the statements of Ibn Abi Mulayka is the fuqaha al-tabi'in, the fuqaha of the tabi'in. And that is Ibrahim ibn Yazid al-Nakha'i. Ibrahim ibn Yazid al-Nakha'i, who died 96 Hijriyah. 96 Hijriyah, he's a tabi'i. Al-Imam Abu Bakr ibn Abi Shayba, who died here 235 Hijriyah, he narrated bi isnadin sahihin with an authentic chain in his musannaf. Qala, he said, haddathana waqi'. Waqi' here is Waqi' ibn Jarrah al-Ru'asi. That is Waqi' ibn Jarrah al-Ru'asi. An Sufyan. Sufyan here is Sufyan ibn Sa'id ibn Masruq al-Thawri. An Mansur, an Ibrahim ibn Yazid al-Nakha'i. And I want, as a side benefit, to remember this. In the Kitab Ilal al-Tirmidhi, Imam al-Tirmidhi in his Ilal, he mentions that Imam al-Bukhari, who he said, because some people might say, Abdurrahman, this chain that you're bringing right now is a weak chain, because we know Sufyan al-Thawri is a mudallis and he done tadlis here. He said, an Mansur, and so this chain is weak. Why are you quoting it? I want to say to these people who might say this, that Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, as Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated in his Ilal, that Imam al-Bukhari, he said, la a'rifu li Sufyan al-Thawri. I do not know for Sufyan al-Thawri. An Habib ibn Abi Thabit, wala an Salamat ibn Kuhayl, wala an Mansur, la a'rifu li Sufyan an ha'ula'i tadlisa. Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, he said, I do not know for Sufyan al-Thawri that he narrated from Habib ibn Abi Thabit, or Salamat ibn Kuhayl, or Mansur. I don't know that he narrated from these three, and then he done tadlis when he narrated from them. Ya'ani, Bukhari is trying to say that Salamat ibn Kuhayl, or Habib ibn Abi Thabit, or Mansur, none of their narration that when Sufyan al-Thawri narrates with an is mudallis, or is tadlis. Pay attention to that and keep that in mind. So this narration I mentioned from Ibn Abi Shayba is sahih. Even though Sufyan al-Thawri, he said an Mansur, because Mansur is from the people that Bukhari mentioned that Sufyan al-Thawri doesn't do tadlis with. Okay? What is it that he narrated from him? Mansur. So Sufyan al-Thawri narrated from Mansur that Ibrahim al-Nakha'i, he said, kariha an yaqula. Ibrahim al-Nakha'i disliked, he hated that a person says qira'atu fulanin وَكَمَا كَانَ يَقْرَأُ فُلَانٍ. This is the qira'ah of so-and-so, and this is how so-and-so recites. He never liked that. Why didn't Ibrahim al-Nakha'i not like that? Why was he against that? Let the imam of this field, Ibn al-Jazari, explain to us, as he mentioned in his kitab, Munjid al-Muqri'in, that when he brought the salaf not liking a person saying, this is the qira'ah of so-and-so, and this is the recitation of so-and-so, or this is how so-and-so read, he explained what it is meant. Ibn al-Jazari says, in his kitab Munjid al-Muqri'in, he said, kariha man kariha min al-salafi, that some of the salaf disliked and hated, and yunsab al-qira'ata ila ahadin, that the qira'ah is attributed to a particular person. And then he said, rawa ibn Abi Dawood, Ibn Abi Dawood, the son of Abi Dawood, Abu Bakr ibn Abi Dawood, he narrated from Ibrahim al-Nakha'i, qala, he said, kanu yakrahuna sanad fulan wa qira'at fulan, that the salaf used to dislike a person say that this is the recitation of so and so and this is the chain of so and so. Then Ibn al-Jazari comments, he says, qultu, I say, wa dhalika khawfan mimma tawahhamahu Abu Shama. The reason why Ibrahim al-Nakha'i and the salaf in general did not like to say this is the recitation of so-and-so and this is the how so-and-so read, is they were scared that confusion may come as it has come to Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi. Which was, what's the confusion? Min anna al-qira'ata idha nusiba ila shakhsin takunu ahadiyya. That if the qira'ah is attributed to one person, it becomes to the people, or they start thinking that the qira'ah is only one person. When they hear that this is the qira'ah of Asim, or this is the qira'ah of Nafi', they might think, okay, only one person narrated this Quran. Quran is not mutawatir. Quran is ahad. وَلَمْ يَدْرِ أَنَّ كُلَّ قِرَاءَةٍ نُسِبَتْ إِلَىٰ قَارِئٍ مِنْ هَؤُلَاءِ كَانَ قُرَّاؤُهَا زَمَنَ قَارِئِهَا وَقَبْلَهُ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ قُرَّائِهَا فِي هَذَا الزَّمَانِ وَأَضْعَافِهِمْ. Ibn al-Jazari, rahimahullah, he says, these people do not know that every reciter who the recitation was attributed to from the seven, or the 10, that the Qur'an that were reading with that 7 or with that 10, the other reciters who were out there reading the Qur'an with him, are more than him. And the ones who were reading this recitation before him were more than him. Okay? And those who came after are also more than him. And there's more people who read in the qira'at of Asim before and after. And people reading it before Asim even came. Then he said, وَمِمَّا يَزِيدُ تَحْقِيقًا. Ibn al-Jazari said that what makes the matter even more clearer is ما قاله أبو حاتم السجستاني. That which Abu Hatim al-Sijistani said. Which, what did he say? He said, أَوَّلُ مَن تَتَبَّعَ بِالْبَصْرَةِ وُجُوهَ الْقِرَاعَةِ. Now you might think to yourself, really? Listen to this. Listen to this example that Ibn al-Jazari gives to show you the matter is very clear. That the issue of the qira'at was already done in large number before that, before any of these seven came. Look what he said, Al-Imam Ibn al-Jazari. He said, what proves this point is the statement of Abu Hatim al-Sijistani, which he said, أَوَّلُ مَن تَتَبَّعَ بِالْبَصْرَةِ وُجُوهَ الْقِرَاءَةِ وَأَلَّفَهَا وَتَتَبَّعَ الشَّاذَّ مِنْهَا. The first person to go out there and gather all the qira'at together, whether it be the accepted qira'at or the rejected qira'at, the first person who brought it all together is Harun ibn Musa al-A'war. وَكَانَ مِنَ الْقُرَّاءِ. And he was from the reciters. Okay? فَكَرِهَ النَّاسُ ذَلِكَ. The people disliked what Harun ibn Musa did. Why did they like it? وَقَالُوا, they said, قَدْ أَسَاءَ حِينَ أَلَّفَهَا. He has done wrong when he started to author in this field. وَذَلِكَ, the reason is because أَنَّ الْقِرَاءَةَ إِنَّمَا تَأْخُذُهَا قُرُونٌ وَأُمَّةٌ عَنْ أَفْوَاهِ أُمَّةٍ. He said the reason is because the people didn't like it is because he gave the impression that the qira'ah was from particular individuals. And they didn't like that. They knew that the qira'at was from large number of people. Restricting a number of people makes it look like the Qur'an is only restricted to these people. And there's no other people who narrated this qira'ah. That's why they didn't like it. They knew that the Qur'an came from large number of people to large number of people. وَلَا يُلْتَفَتُ مِنْهَا إِلَى مَا جَاءَ مِنْ رَاوٍ يعني آحَادٍ آحَادٍ. Ibn al-Jazari says. Harun ibn Musa lived in the second century. He died before 200. And Imam Abu Hatim al-Sijistani, who's saying this statement, he died, rahimahullah, when the year was 255 Hijriah. What does that show you? That the qira'at was known, studied, accumulated, acquired, and mastered before any of the imams had already come. Before any of the reciters of the qira'at came, the Qur'an was gathered, it was taken on board. Na'am. Now, inshallah ta'ala, I want to go in giving you an example of some of the seven qira'at that we have. Just to show you that the tabi'een, to the atba'u tabi'een, it was all done. Qur'an was really done. Now, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to give two examples. The first example I'm going to give, inshallah ta'ala, is Asim ibn Abi Najud, whose qira'ah is the one read by majority of the Muslims around the world today. It's the most famous one. Asim, he died the year 128 Hijriah. Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid said in his kitab, Kitab al-Sab'ah, al-Qira'at, he says, حدثني ابن شاكر قال حدثنا يحيى بن آدم عن أبي بكر بن عياش قال لا أحصي ما سمعت أبا إسحاق السبيعي يقول ما رأيت أحدا أقرأ للقرآن من عاصم بن أبي نجود ما استثنى أحدا من أصحاب عبد الله. أبو بكر بن مجاهد, who died year 334 هجرية, he has a kitab called السبعة, and we've already spoken about it. He brought his chain, which is all authentic, that Abu Bakr ibn Ayyash said, I can't count how many times I heard Abu Ishaq al-Sabi'i say. Abu Ishaq al-Sabi'i said the following, ما رأيت, I never saw أحدا أقرأ للقرآن, a person who mastered the Qur'an, who had read the Qur'an, who had studied the Qur'an, better than who Asim ibn Abi Najud. ما استثنى أحدا, he did not leave off any of the students of who? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Asim ibn Abi Najud did not leave off. مَسْتَثْنَا أَحَدًا مِنْ أَصْحَابِ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ. And he never loved any of the students of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Asim ibn Abi Najud took from Ali ibn Abi Talib, and he took from the Qur'an. His chain goes to Ali ibn Abi Talib, and it goes to Uthman ibn Affan, and it goes through Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. He took from many of the companion students. So the Tabi'in passed on to him. He took it from all of the students of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. He took from Abdullah ibn Habib, about Uthman al-Sulami. He took from Zir ibn Hubaysh. And he asked me, Abin Najud, his qira'ah is taken from a lot of the tabi'in. And then the tabi'in were passing on to the tabi'u tabi'in. The tabi'u tabi'in. Second example. Nafi', who was one of the seven qurra, Nafi' ibn Abdul Rahman ibn Abi Nu'aym, who died in 169 Hijriah. He said, Imam Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid narrated in his kitab al-Sab'a again, he said, حدثني أبو سعيد المفضل ابن محمد بن إبراهيم بمكة قال حدثنا أبو حمد محمد بن يوسف قال حدثنا أبو قرة سمعت نافعا يقول نافع بن عبد الرحمن ابن أبي نعيم said قرأت على 70 من التابعين. I read on to 70 of the تابعين. نافع saying this. I read on to 70 of the تابعين. Is that not multitude, mass transmission? 70 of the tabi'in I narrated it from. This issue carried on. I gave you two examples. This issue of studying the Qur'an in this way, in large number, carried on. Until Abu al-Qasim al-Hudali came, at the year 465 Hijriah. He died the year 465 Hijriah. He traveled the world to take the Qur'an and the qira'at. And he took the Qur'an from hundreds of shuyukh. Ibn al-Jazari mentions in his kitab Munjid al-Muqri'in, he said, أن الإمام الراوية أبا القاسم الهذلي الذي رحل المشرق والمغرب وأخذ القرآن من 365 شيخا. He took the Qur'an from how many people? 365 shuyukh he took the Qur'an from. And he said about himself, رَحَلْتُ مِنْ آخِرِ الْمَغْرِبِ إِلَىٰ بَابِ الْفَرْغَانَةِ يَمِينًا وَشِمَالًا وَجَبَلًا وَبَحْرًا. He said, I traveled the world to take it. Abu al-Qasim al-Hudali. Another great scholar, Shamsuddin al-Dhahabi, who died in the year 748 Hijriah. Al-Imam al-Dhahabi's teachers reached Shuyukh Alf Shaykh, 1,000 teachers. Ibn al-Jazari, Shamsuddin ibn al-Jazari, he has a kitab called Ghayatul Nihaya fi al-Tabaqat al-Qurra. He said, Abu Abdullah al-Dhahabi, al-Hafiz, Ustadh, Thiqa, Kabir, Wulid sana 73 and 600. He said that Al-Imam Abu al-Dhahabi, he's a Hafiz, a scholar, a teacher, a reliable person. Imam al-Dhahabi was born which year? Sanata 73 and 600. He was born 673 Hijriah. And then he said, وَعُنِيَ بِالْقِرَاءَةِ مِنْ صِغَارِهِ. He gave importance to the Qur'an when he was young. وَشْتَغَلَ بِالْحَدِيثِ. He busied himself with hadith and the narrators. فَبَلَغَتْ شُيُوخُهُ. His teachers reached في الحديث, just in hadith, وغيري, and all the other sciences in Islam, ألفاً. It reached 1,000. فبلغت شيوخ في الحديث وغيره ألفاً. His teachers in hadith and other than hadith, it reached 1,000. And this proves to us that this Quran came through mass transmission. بجميع قراءاته الصحيحة. With all of the قراءات which are صحيحة. بطريق تواتر, it reached us through تواتر, جيلا بعد جيل, generations after generation, ليتحقق الحفظ الذي تكفل الله به. And this is without a doubt to show that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's statement is true. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. that we send down the revelation and we're going to protect it. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to see you bi'idhnillahi al-kareem in the next episode. BarakAllahu feekum wa jazakumullahu khayran for listening.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.